Coming right up in this video, we're going to do a quick tutorial to show you how to make a water rocket launcher for Gardena-style nozzles. Then we're going to show you how the launcher works in action. We're going to wrap it up by giving you a quick sneak peek preview of a couple of our more complicated long-term projects, and see who can guess what we're cooking up in our Skunk Works. Stick around, that's all coming up next. A number of people who downloaded our 3D printed water rocket nozzles from Thingiverse have asked where they can purchase a suitable launcher for them. We decided to make this video to present a quick tutorial showing you how you can make a compatible water rocket launcher that uses a Gardena hose quick release connector for the release mechanism. If you have all the materials on hand, you should be able to build this launcher in an hour or less and be out there launching water rockets in no time. This type of launcher also works with handmade Gardena nozzles in addition to our 3D printed nozzles, so you don't need a 3D printer at all for this project. As usual, the description below has all the important links referenced in this video as well as the online text version. Let's get building. To make the Gardena launcher, you only need a few items from the hardware store: PVC pipe cement, a tire Schrader valve, a 1/2 inch PVC slip-to-slip elbow, a 3/4 inch female thread to slip adapter, a hose quick connector with male threads, a 1/2 inch slip to 3/4 inch slip adapter, a 1/2 inch female threaded cap, a 1/2 inch male thread to 1/2 inch slip adapter, Teflon thread tape, electrical tape, about 18 inches of 1/2 inch PVC pipe, some scrap wood, 2 screw eyelets, a pair of U-bolts, some string or thin rope. Begin by cutting 2 pieces of PVC pipe. One piece should be about 10 to 12 inches long and the other one should be about 2 to 3 inches long. The dimensions are not really that important. Next, we start to build the release head. Take the hose quick connect and wrap the threads with a few layers of Teflon tape and thread it into the 3/4 inch slip to 3/4 inch female thread adapter. If you live in the USA, you will find that the Gardena threads do not match exactly, but the Teflon tape combined with some effort on your part will force the threads together and it won't leak. Next, we glue the 1/2 inch slip to 3/4 inch slip adapter to the release head. Glue the short piece of PVC pipe you just cut into the release head next. You can now glue the 1/2 inch PVC elbow to the release head. Glue the longer piece of PVC pipe to the elbow. The last piece that you need to glue to the release head is the 1/2 inch male thread to slip adapter. Your next step is to mount the Schrader valve so that you have a place to connect the air supply to the launcher. Installing the Schrader valve is very easy. Take the 1/2 inch female threaded cap and drill an 8 mm hole through the center of the end. You can now install the Schrader valve by pushing it through from the inside. The trick to installing the Schrader valve is to take a rod or a Phillips screwdriver and push it into the hole at the bottom of the Schrader valve and push it firmly from the inside out until it snaps in place. Then you can screw the cap onto your launcher. The last step is to make a base to hold the launcher in the upright position. You can use the 2 U-bolts to secure the launcher to a piece of scrap lumber, or you can build a more elaborate launcher base from wood or other material. That part we leave to your imagination and creativity. Here we have a nicely painted launcher base, which we built some time ago for our Clark Cable Tie launcher tutorial. If you want to make a base like this, you can follow the link in the description for that project. When the launcher is mounted into the base, be careful not to over-tighten the U-bolts, which can cause the PVC pipe to crack. Now you place a screw eye on either side of the Gardena release mechanism to contain and direct the release string. Use electrical tape to secure a length of string to either side of the release mechanism and through each screw eye. Now when you pull the release, the rocket can launch. You can now tie the remaining string to the center of the release string to extend it so you can launch the rocket from a safe distance. The last thing you need is a water rocket. You can launch just about any empty soft drink bottle by attaching a Gardner-style nozzle to it, or you can build a much more complex water rocket, which will fly much higher and go much straighter. Here we have a water rocket made from 3 2-liter bottles spliced together with box fins and a nose cone. Tutorial links for all these designs are available in the description. No matter what water rocket design you're using, it's now time to launch. To fire this rocket, all you need to do is fill it 1/3 of the way with water, screw on the nozzle, lock it into place on the launcher, connect your air supply, and then fill it with air. When you reach the target pressure, you can then pull the release string and the rocket will take to the air. Remember to be safe when you're launching and always have fun. We hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like so we know you want to see more like it. Since you've been dedicated enough to watch this video all the way to the end, we're going to give you a special sneak peek at some of our upcoming long-term projects we've been working on. Do you have any idea what these projects might be? Let us know in the comments if you have a guess or if you think you've figured it out. Be sure and check out some of our other water rocket videos if you like this one, and don't forget to subscribe because it really helps our channel. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.